What's good, everybody, and welcome back to my channel, Smoking and Grilling with me, AB. Now, that's right, you guys seen that thumbnail, you seen that flyby, you know, that little piece of video right there, and you already read that name, right? So you know what we're getting ready to make. I'm getting ready to show you guys just how simple and easy it is to make, you know, some delicious pinto beans. But check it out. This year, I'm kind of like focusing on, you know, we getting over, you know, because a lot of people out there don't use that pork, right? So we're going to flavor this with that chicken stock, or you guys can use chicken broth, whichever one. And listen, this is the level up right here. We're going to go ahead and use turkey wings. Super easy. I promise you this. And then I want you guys to look up here at these eye cards right here. You're going to see that I made like a, pick one. It doesn't make no difference. Just pick any of these cornbreads and you will be successful. I promise you that. Hey, so I don't over talk it. I feel like I'm rambling. Let's get it. Okay, so look, let's start off with talking about the beans. Now, if you guys look, let me bring it a little closer. I'm gonna take my finger like this. You can see that it still has water in it, right? I pre-soaked my beans overnight. These been soaking for about 9 hours. This is what you wanna do when you think about it and you say, I wanna have beans, you know, to start them tomorrow. Most people are probably not gonna remember that. So what you can do is get yourself a pot, you boil the water. After you boil the water and it starts to boil, then you just remove it from the heat, add your beans, cover your pot, and let it soak for 1 hour. And that's the same as soaking it, you know, overnight. So that's called a hot flash. I do that also, but this time I had the foresight to soak it. Now, let's go ahead and talk about this right here. Now listen, this is where we're gonna get our flavor from, right? Look, we got 6 cups of chicken broth. Now this chicken broth can be chicken broth, it could be chicken stock, you know, whatever you guys have in your cabinet, but I suggest that you have both of these or one or the other. You know, you want to keep at least 4 cartons of this all, you know, throughout the holiday, because I cook a lot. This is where we're going to get the flavor, right? And we're going to have 6 cups of this. Now, we got a jalapeno, right? You want to get yourself one of these because you're going to need to have that little bit of a, just a little bit of heat. A lot of people think when you put a jalapeno in there, it's going to be super hot. You know what I mean? But inside this is going to be real smooth. It just gives it a little bit of a bite. Right? I'm gonna go ahead and chop this up a little bit on the fine side. Then you gotta get yourself an onion. You know what? We're gonna chop this onion. You know, just a rough chop to give it that flavor, right? We got garlic powder. And here, we got black pepper. And then of course, you guys know, love flipping this over. We got kosher salt. Now, to show you the star of everything, now, let's talk about the turkey wings. This is where we're gonna get our flavor from also, right? So we got chicken broth, turkey wings, and look, they smoke. So I got a couple of videos I'm gonna have out for you guys so you guys can get prepared for, the, you know, next year. We're gonna start smoking our turkey, you know, our ham shank, stuff like that. And then what you do is you just vacuum seal them and then you can put them in the oven. I mean, excuse me, put them in your deep freezer and you'll have them and you'll always have them. Okay, now take a look right here. I've already drained them. You can see that if I move my finger like this, you can see there's no more water, right? I already drained these. Look, and I didn't say this earlier, but I'm gonna be using my Dutch oven. Obviously, you guys can see that now, so I'm gonna go ahead and just add this to my Dutch oven. And now, what I wanna do is, I wanna go ahead and put my 6 cup of my chicken broth in here. So, let's fill this up. All right, so now we just wanna get 6 cups, right? Okay, right here, look, that was 4 cups. Then we follow up with 2 for a total of 6, right? So this is just showing you, you know, everything that's going inside of, you know, your Dutch oven or whatever you're using. Okay, so now we talk about just getting a chop, right? So I'm just gonna go ahead. Okay, so as you can see, obviously I got them peeled, right? So I'm just finna make it, I'm just finna chop it. You know what I mean? Just. That's good enough for me. To the Dutch oven, you know, like that. They're gonna come apart, soften up, put a lot of flavor in the beans, right? So now, what I wanna do is, check this out. I got myself, look at this, I got some gloves, because listen, I've been learning the hard way about fooling with these jalapenos. So let me get my gloves on, then we're gonna dice these up. And then we go from there. All right, so let's go ahead, get this going. I'm gonna go ahead and take these seeds out, because listen, we don't want it to be like super hot, right? So I'll just use the tip of the knife. Take this out like that. Kind of like just clean, you know, get these out of here. Now that's right, I can hear y'all now in the comment section saying AB might be a lightweight. Yes sir, when it comes to that heat, I don't get down like that, like everybody probably think I do. So what I'm gonna do is remove these, then we're gonna go ahead and chop. Okay, so on the meat side, right, go ahead and take your knife, you know, just cut them down like how you see I'm doing right here. Sorry if my hand was in the way. But look, just like that, right? We do the same thing with this one. Now, just put them together, and then we'll just make a little dice, right? So here we go. All right, so now I'm gonna take my garlic powder, add that. I'm gonna go ahead and add my black pepper. Right, and what I wanna do is I wanna bring this to a simmer. So we'll go ahead and start it now. Once it starts to simmer, then we're gonna go ahead and add our turkey to it also. Real simple. Let me go ahead and open this up and get these ready. All right, so obviously you guys can see I got the turkey wings, you know, outside of the packaging, right? So look at this, you can see the flavor. You can see that color right there, and I wish you guys could smell it. Now, let's just go ahead, open this up. Oh yeah, that right there is right. What I'm doing is reducing it. That's a little bit more than I wanted. I wanted it to be more of a simmer. So I just removed that. Remember, this is an induction top, so the heating element is right underneath the bottom, right? So now, I'm gonna go ahead and take my turkey. I'm just gonna put it inside, just like you see right here. Now you want to talk about flavor, this is going to be it right here. You guys got to trust me when I tell you that. So now I'm just stirring this around, making sure that that gets all of the chicken, you know, broth, or if you guys use, you know, stock, whichever one. And we're going to let this simmer inside of this. I'm going to say for about, I'm going to set a timer for 1 hour, then we'll come back and take a look at it. You know what I mean? Then we're gonna check and see how soft the beans are and see if it's time to go ahead and shred some of that meat off of those wings so that we can have that flavor. So let me put the top on. Now I'm gonna set a timer. Alexa, set a timer for 1 hour.
1 hour, starting now.
Okay, now look, it's been 1 hour, right? Probably been about 1 hour and 5 minutes. I've been dragging my feet, but I know that nothing is like so crucial that the extra 5 minutes is gonna set me off, right? So we good there. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and open this. Go ahead and reduce that down a little bit. I'm gonna move this around just to see how it's starting to boil. See how it's starting to soften up? This turkey is gonna be fall off the bone in about another hour. Now, what I wanna do is, check this out. We're gonna go ahead, I'm gonna add a teaspoon of salt. I'm gonna start there, and what I wanna do now is I just wanna give it a stir. Reason being, you guys been following me know that I'm, you know, been cutting back on my salt intake, you know what I mean? Cause we gotta watch us. You know, we got that little high blood pressure, that hypertension, you know, is running rampant throughout the country. So listen, we just wanna go ahead and train our palate to not have so much, you know, give it a stir and then taste it. If anything, I'll add just, I'm gonna say I'll probably add myself maybe a half a teaspoon more. But right now we just wanna stir it. You can see that color, look at that. Starting to look at the color in the liquid. Now it's starting to, you know, become the what we all know and love about pinto beans, right? But no worries. Now let's go like this. You remember, right? I always tell everybody, listen, you gotta taste your food and you season as you go. So what I'm gonna do is, it almost made me want to grab one of these turkey wings and throw it up against the wall. That right there, it don't need no more salt. Now, okay, give it a little stir. I like this right here. Hey, this turkey brought a whole lot of flavor, you guys. Hey, we got to start, you know, using them other pieces of meats too. Now, got that done. Let me go ahead and get this top. I reduced it. You can see it reduced down to a simmer. Now I'm gonna set another timer for about an hour. We probably wanna go an hour and a half, maybe. I'm gonna just look at it in an hour, and then if I need to add 30 more minutes onto it, I will. So, Alexa, set a bean timer for 1 hour.
Bean timer, 1 hour, starting now.
Okay, let's take a look at it. This is exactly, I'm gonna say 2 hour-ish. Here we go. You can just see how soft this turkey is. Look, it's starting to fall off the bone. Oh man, this right here. Just telling me we're gonna go another hour. I'm gonna go ahead and do a bean check just to see how soft it is. Look at these onions, y'all. But let's go ahead and just take a bean. Oh man, they right about there. But I can tell you this, you can cook beans as long as you would like. Okay, now look, I look at the broth and you can see the color right there, right? That's what we're looking for. Now, there's gonna be ways we're gonna thicken that up. We can use that cornstarch slurry to thicken this up. We could take the top off and let it cook, you know, cook down and evaporate some of this and let it thicken it up. I'll make my decision in just a minute. I'm gonna say, so right now we've been going 2 hours. Let's just go ahead and let it go for one more hour. Let's get this turkey to be just a little bit, you know, more on the soft side, you know, so we can shred it and add it. So I'm gonna set one more timer for another hour and we're gonna go from there. Okay, it's been 3 hours, right? Haven't looked at it, haven't done nothing. So let's go ahead and just take this top off. And now you guys are seeing it like that. That right there, if this ain't pinto beans, I don't know what is. Now look, I haven't looked at it or nothing since the last time. Look at how the smoked turkey is just falling off of this bone. Look at this right here. It's almost all off of here. And then of course, if we take one of these beans and we bring it up here on the side like this, oh yeah, this right here is right. Look at that color. Again, if you guys want to taste it, but all you're going to do is taste it and then eating some more, blah, blah, blah. So what I'm going to do now is, I don't want to like mash all the beans. I'm just going to go ahead, move some of these, get some of this meat off of the bone so we can get the actual meat inside of the beans. And then what we're going to do is we're going to put some rice in the bowl and then we're going to go ahead and, you know, plate it. So super simple. Let me just go ahead. I'll probably put some gloves on, you know, and then we're gonna go ahead and get this meat off of this bone. Okay, so got the bones out, as you guys can see right here. Now look, I got a bowl. I went ahead and put some rice in it. So now let's just go ahead and scoop it. I don't think it needs to be thickened any. We just gonna add this right here on top, just the way you see. Oh yeah, look at this right here, folks. Get a little bit of that, turkey meat. And then, when I talk about the juice, right? This right here, the meat is the real pot liquor. You know, that's what I call it. We're gonna pour this over the top like that. Ah, yeah. Now, I know that's a big bowl, but what I'm gonna do is, let me go ahead and get me a fork. All right, y'all just seen it. You know what I mean? My mouth is watering. You see this? Take a look at that right there. Tell me, if your mouth is not watering right now, something is wrong. But anyway, I'm not finna overtalk it. Let's go ahead and get it, because I'm ready to just taste some of this. Now, I like to stay honest with you guys and let y'all know that yes, I've already tasted a little bit, because I taste as I go. I can tell you right now, this is fire. So, cheers. Now, to make sure that I'm just not tripping because it's my food. And you see this right here? Don't forget, check out my cornbread. This ought to be a shame. All right, I don't want to like overdo it. You guys just saw it. When I tell you it's right, it's right. You guys gotta trust the process. You gotta put a little time under it. It could be 3 hours. It depends on what your version is and how you're cooking it, what your simmer is to you, you know, things like that. So I'm gonna just say these went for about three and a half hours total. Listen, the smoked turkey was fall off the bone. And we try to do things a little bit more on the healthier side, right? So if you guys are using that chicken, let's see, that would be the chicken broth. Don't forget, you guys can use that low sodium, that 33% low sodium. That right there, and listen, that's for all of us that's watching our sodium, you know, that hypertension, you know what I mean, that high blood pressure, that whole thing. Listen, we're gonna train our palate this holiday season so that we can, you know, eat just a little bit of salt, just enough to wake it up, tell that, you know, your palate to send that signal to your brain that this is fire. Hey, so with that being said, I don't want to over talk it. Now, listen, if you're new to my channel, let me just take this time to say, hey, thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, smash that like button, and tell everybody out there there's a channel out here that's simplifying these recipes and taking the mystery out of cooking. Hey, and you know what I'm about to say. With that being said, what? I'm out of here. Peace.